Now Congress must demonstrate the same bipartisanship again and join together to pass the Senate bill as written and avoid playing any more partisan games. They have to get together and just stop with the partisan politics. It must go quickly. It's not really a choice. They don't have a choice. They have to make a deal.
They do have to make a deal, and they haven't yet. Let's bring in Senator John Cornyn, Republican from Texas, member of the Senate Judiciary Committee and Senate Select Intelligence Committee. Good morning to you, Senator.
Good morning, Ainsley.
Good morning. So no relief package. Democrats have rejected the Republican bill. They want to include money for the Kennedy Center. They want to include same-day registration, voting registration, wind and solar tax credits. Has nothing to do with coronavirus. The words, the adjectives I've heard to describe this: selfish, shameful, disgraceful, embarrassing. What's your reaction?
Well, everybody knows this is a national emergency, but this is like shooting the tires out in the fire truck that's going to put out the fire. These are people who are getting paid to show up for work, and there are many people through no fault of their own aren't getting paid anything, and we need to get money to them to help bridge them through this crisis.
Good point.
You know, Senator, in listening to the conversation on Capitol Hill and the floor of the Senate yesterday, you would have thought that the Democrats had no input on this, but that's simply not true. You know, last week, Mitch McConnell told Republican committee chairs to work with the Democrats on planks of the legislation. They used a number of the ideas that were from the House as well. Everybody thought that the deal was done. And in fact, I think on Saturday night, Chuck Schumer said he was delighted and surprised at the bipartisan cooperation until Nancy Pelosi came back with a 1,000-page bill. And suddenly, all those things that they've been talking about for so long, magically in the COVID bill. Not surprising, it's politics.
Yeah, this is all about leverage. Unfortunately, the American people don't have time to wait on these games to get the help they need, nor do the hospitals or the businesses that are shut through no fault of their own. We need to make sure that when we get out of this health care crisis that there are jobs there for the American people so the economy can start booming again and so people can provide for their families. But unfortunately, they're having to wait because of this idea of leverage. Democrats feel like they've got a bill that must pass, and it must. So they're trying to extract everything they can, all their ideological wish list, and it is just shameful.
So, Senator, having said all that, and I don't think there's another side to this, we saw the list, and we see that Nancy Pelosi thinks you guys are vulnerable because five different Republicans are forced to quarantine one positive for the coronavirus. Having said all that, suddenly we hear there's going to be a deal this morning. Did you guys give in?
Secretary Mnuchin is representing the president and the administration. Mitch McConnell and Kevin McCarthy are representing our side of the negotiations. The list is getting shorter, but again, I think what Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi realize is that this is a must-pass piece of legislation. We have to do this, and they're extracting every last dollar they can. You can't try to outbid or outspend folks on the left, and they see this as a golden opportunity. But again, there's a time for politics and there's a time to be responsible. This is reckless and irresponsible. We need to get this done today.
Senator, for folks that are watching that have had to close their businesses or are worried that they're going to have to, or employees that aren't making money, they're furloughed, especially the restaurant industry, what can they expect to come out of this bill? Because they're watching, they're thinking, oh, that's Washington. How do I even get that money? Who do I call? How do I get a check?
Well, we're doing this through the Internal Revenue Service so people can literally get a direct deposit into their account because, of course, all those accounts are already established. And then the beefed up unemployment insurance will kick in next after people get their initial cash payment. And hopefully they will then be able to ride that out. Meantime, we need to provide some stabilization to small businesses so they can maintain those businesses so they'll still exist and those jobs will still exist when we come out of this crisis. And then, of course, they're the big employers that employ hundreds of thousands of people. Democrats call that a slush fund, but, you know, these are important companies that provide the jobs. And I never have understood here on Capitol Hill where some people who claim to love the worker hate the very person who provides that worker the job. And so we've got to take care of this across the board.
Senator, you know, we heard from the president yesterday in the form of a tweet where he said we can't let the cure be worse than the problem itself. You know, he's going to look at the end of this week at where we are regarding COVID-19. And it sounds like he's hinting that he may reopen parts of the economy, which is something everybody would like. But the practicality of it is they still haven't cured COVID-19, and we haven't quite figured out how to stop the spread. What's your concern about that?
Well, I think what the president is saying is we need to have a balance. We need to stop the spread of this virus, but we can't kill our economy because it's our economy which actually allows us to pay for the miracle cures that we're hoping for, the vaccine and the other relief that we're now providing to the American people. So I understand his concern, and we're all trying to figure out what that balance is. And that's why I think we're looking at this on a day-by-day basis. It's hard to make predictions about what life might be like 2 weeks from now, because look back 2 weeks ago, where we were then.
Yeah, it's frustrating. Senator Cornyn, look forward to get something done. And if you can make a stand for the future negotiations in crises like this, you should not give in on any of that checklist, because it's all about an agenda. It's not about the country. Senator Cornyn, thanks so much.
Thanks, Brian.
Thanks, Senator.